leaning on anything. Bring your back, your spine upright. Open your chest and relax your shoulders. Let your eyes either be half closed and downcast or completely closed, but don't tighten up in your head. Relax your face, relax all the muscles around your eyes, your forehead, your mouth. Relax around your throat, open your throat up as if you are sighing, that kind of openness to your throat. Relax your shoulders. If you're gently descending within the body experience. Notice how it's changing, notice how it's one thing after another, it's not the same thing, it's different sensations running through. Sometimes you feel you want to fidget a little bit. Take some time to get to feel comfortable. Arrange your legs, arrange your hands so they feel they can rest. Take a few long out-breaths. So for each out-breath, you're dropping, you're letting go of things, letting go of what's outside your body. You don't need it right now, everything's safe. Just let go of what's outside your body with every out-breath. Take it slowly and see how long and slow that out-breath could become. You can take it right the way down. Chest through your belly to below the navel, all the way down through to the base of the body, breathing out. And notice the pause between the out-breath and the in-breath. See if you can lengthen that pause. Lengthen the pause as if you're not going to breathe in, but you wait until the in-breath really wants to happen. Breath comes, slow it down, breathe through, let the in-breath come in through the nostrils as if you're gently drawing in through a straw, so it's not a gulp, a slow, steady drawing in, filling up the base of the body, the midriff, the chest, the throat. It slows down, let it continue to draw in until it's finished. And wait a little while until the out-breath wants to happen. This is the way that you change gear from busy movements of the mind to something more embodied, deeper, firmer, less subject to agitation, calm. you could even develop that gear change by, when you come to the end of your out-breath, wait, and when the in-breath starts to happen, just don't breathe in, give it another few seconds, 3 or 4 seconds before you breathe in, so you can quite deliberately regulate and downshift your energy. So it feels that your mind and body are starting to settle into each other, your mind isn't racing away. And you can be with the rhythm of breathing in and breathing out, feeling the sensations of that experience. The result of this is when your mind isn't busy figuring things out, it has a lot more sensitivity, so it's more aware. The sense of receptivity and listening and attention in the mind deepens, and you experience a sense of observation or witnessing, watchfulness, mindfulness, full awareness. You really can notice and be sensitive to something simple like breathing in and breathing out. And the quality of the sensitivity is such that it becomes kind of pleasant, gentle, tender. Because the habits are strong, the mind runs away. To when you recognize your mind is drifting off or running away, think the thought, where is the breathing? Where is my breath now? And see if you can find the next out-breath. So this is the way you gently bring it back. It's not a tug of war. It's not an aggressive practice, it's a gentle practice of acknowledgement, and then, oh, it's interesting, now where is the breathing? Breathe, bring your mind back to the breathing, relax, empty out the thought and the emotion by not engaging in them. So you feel more comfortable with that process, then find a place in your body where your mind can sit to contemplate breathing in, breathing out, the rhythms of it, the feelings of it. Could be in your chest or your belly, or the back of your nose, back of your throat, but your mind will find a place where it feels it wants to settle down, let the breath flow over it. who is comfortable that way. And then we can start to notice the sensations, but also the energies of the breathing in, breathing out. There's an energy there. When you breathe in, there's a feeling of brightening, rising. When you breathe out, there's this energy which is to do with relaxing, diffusing, softening. And these two energies are very helpful for the mind. They're like a massage for the mind. The softening and the letting go, you get a sense of being able to relax and come out of the spin of thoughts and moods. And then with the brightening, you get the sense of sharpening and clarity and acuteness. These will provide a very blended or comfortable quality, the energy that feels agreeable. As it develops, it becomes something we call piti, or rapture. It's a kind of uplifted, bright sense. If you can tune into the the energy of the breathing effect on your nervous system, effect on your whole body, widen to breathe as if you're almost like gently blowing up a balloon or inflatable things, breathing through the whole body, through the skin, through the arms, letting that calm energy suffuse the whole body. Then quieter it, calmer and more comfortable it gets, the more your mind can go to the real work of noticing the moment-by-moment change of it all. Change of sensations. Sense of solidity begins to be something that you grow beyond. Yet you have this sense of the mind being really firm, clear, and not agitated. It's an important realization where you enable you to turn your interests more towards the mental, the spiritual, the non-sensual, away from the purely corporeal. Experience the happiness of a mind that is not holding on. Lift your mindfulness from the breathing, allow the breathing to be there, but also start to open up the mental content, the emotional states. Notice what your concerns or feelings are that arise in the present moment. You know, some worry or some planning or uncertainties. Breathe through those as if you're also just experiencing those moment at a time, sensations and energies flow through the mind. See our thoughts and emotions also as something that's not really solid or gripping. It gives you a very helpful insight that you can use when your mind becomes unbalanced or overpowering. breathing through it. As we come to the end of the meditation session, collect yourself around your breathing, your good breathing energy, and bring up, imagine someone you know, as if you're sending them your good wishes, near or far, alive or dead, or even yourself. They bring up the experience of just sending good energy into the world. Even somebody you don't really like, it's very important to send good wishes to people you don't like. It helps to clear your own mind of fear, negativity. Just coming out of the meditation, let your eyes open up without jumping back, but just as if you're allowing the dawn to come through the windows of your eyes.